We made it into Canada.
One order of the shrimp roll, and then two orders of the pork.
The reason why we're making a big deal of getting these spring rolls is because our favorite restaurant to get these spring rolls is from Brodard. And we learned that last year they opened a Brodard Express in the
airport. Yeah, so that's why we're here, and that's why we're trying. Well, and we're flying out, but you know.
That's like how I remembered.
Hey guys.
Hey guys.
So we just arrived at John Wayne Airport and we're gonna be flying up to Washington. We're gonna be taking the ferry from Seattle to Victoria, BC, Canada. And this is gonna be your first time there, right? So how do you feel?
I'm really excited. My mom told me that I was in her stomach when she went up, so it doesn't count. Basically, yeah, we're gonna spend a weekend in Victoria. On Saturday, we're going to be having afternoon tea at the Empress Hotel, which is also the hotel we're staying at too. And then on Sunday, we're going to the Butchart Gardens. I'm really, really, really excited for that one because I saw on their website that it's so beautiful, it's so luscious. There's a lot of greens and flowers and natures to look at. But unfortunately, can't control the weather.
Yeah.
But it's probably gonna be raining on Sunday, yeah. So.
Which is very uncommon in the Pacific Northwest.
Call. Yeah, so and after that, we'll take the ferry back to Seattle, and then we're going to be staying in Washington for a week. We made it into the Edgewater Hotel. Such a beautiful view, close to the water, huh? Mm-hmm. So we just came back from dinner. What'd you think?
It was good. It was on the bougier side, a little bit pricier, and we were kind of underdressed, but I thought it was fine. Food tasted really good. My dish is kind of like a seafood soup, I guess, with fish, shrimp, clams, mussel, and like some a side of like bread that you could dip in the soup. And it was pretty tasty. How was yours?
I really liked mine. Mine was the salmon, but the way how they paired it with the mushroom, they had some bacon, asparagus. Mm-hmm. The flavor of it was really good.
And how about the dessert?
Oh, it was good. At the end, it did start to get a little bit overwhelming.
It's very rich. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'd recommend if you wanted to try something kind of fancy. Mm-hmm.
Let's go do that room tour. Hey, you walk in. This is the bed. I mean, how often do hotels give you a teddy bear? But that's so cute. Not just that, but there's another bear too. Can you spot it? Ha ha ha, that one right there. And then they have a pretend fireplace. I always imagined what it would be like to live in the woods.
Oh yeah?
Or in a cabin.
You're not afraid of like serial killers coming out of the woods?
Head to the restroom. Ooh. Hello vlog.
The plan for tomorrow is we're gonna wake up around 6 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have to go to the Clipper Vacation, which is the ferry port. Mm-hmm.
They start boarding the ferry at 7 and then it departs at 8 to Victoria, British mm-hmm. Columbia. Are you excited?
I'm excited. I was gonna say we're gonna be in Canada tomorrow.
Yay.
Good night.
Good morning, everyone. Today is the next day. Just woke up. It's around 6:30 a.m. We're about to catch the Clipper Vacation Ferry very soon. It's so close from the Edgewater Hotel. It's literally only a 6-minute walk. So that was the reason also why we picked this hotel. So let's go.
Guys, that's literally where we're gonna be going. We're gonna go to the Butchart Garden, and then we're gonna be staying at the Empress Hotel and have afternoon tea there today. Yay! I think we're like pretty much right in the front, huh? We made it into Canada. We're gonna see if we can drop off our luggage at the Fairmont Empress Hotel, and then gonna have afternoon tea.
So we'll do that, and then we'll talk to the staff and see if we can catch one of the buses to the Butchart Gardens, because it's gonna be raining tomorrow. So we're hoping that maybe we'll just check it out today, get a good look, and then tomorrow we could just chill before we have to catch that Clipper back.
We just checked in into the Fairmont Empress. We were able to come in early, so yay! Let's have a room tour. Ooh, they have an espresso machine, because usually the hotels they give Keurigs, but this is an espresso, so that's cool. Then, let's check out the bathroom.
Wow.
Compared to the one yesterday, this is much smaller, but we're just staying here for night, so it's okay.
It's almost 1 p.m. We're gonna go get afternoon tea now.
Yay, get some caffeine.
Afternoon tea at the Fairmont Empress in Victoria, BC is truly a delightful experience. The ambience is elegant and inviting, with a touch of royal charm that transported us to a different era. Each bite is a testament to the culinary excellence that the Fairmont Empress is known for. Among the variety of delicious bites, the chocolate raspberry madeleine was my favorite. It's a perfect blend of sweet and tart, with the richness of the chocolate beautifully balanced by the freshness of the raspberry. It's not just about the tea or the food, it's about the experience, the ambience, the view, the service, and the feeling of being treated like royalty. It's an experience that you wouldn't want to miss. So when you're in Victoria, make sure to make a reservation at the Empress. It's worth it.
We made it into Butchart Gardens.
We're right here. We gotta go all the way around, and then there's the Japanese garden over there.
Okay.
Let's go.
Wow, I didn't even notice this whole tree is covered in bees. Oh, look at that.
Look at that mumbler.
Big one over there.
Look at that big one.
My goodness. Yeah, they really blend in, huh? Sweet little bumblebee, da da da. So we're gonna enter into the sunken garden. Wow. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. It literally looks like a movie, huh? Like a beautiful scenery. It really reminds me of like the Alice in Wonderland movie. Oh, this is so gorgeous. I'm gonna cry.
Out of happiness.
You're so pretty. We can rest a little bit here too.
You enjoying it so far?
Yes. You know, I'm glad we took the Uber instead of taking public transportation.
That's happy anniversary.
Oh yes, happy anniversary. Wow, that is so beautiful.
Look at that caterpillar.
Ready to become a beautiful butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
So it is starting to drizzle a little bit, but it's so wonderful that they let you rent these clear plastic umbrellas for free. So that's very thoughtful of them. Happy 2024, Year of the Dragon. Let's go back to Japan. Wow, this is so beautiful. Well, my favorite garden is the sunken garden. The reason why it's my favorite garden is because it was very hidden, so it really awestruck me.
Yeah, I agree. I like that the best. I thought the Japanese garden was kind of underwhelming. And for the rose garden, a lot of the roses weren't even blooming yet.
Oh, yeah.
Only a few. All right, well, it's time to head back, right?
Yeah, dinner time soon.
Yep.
Interesting brand of root beer, huh? Spaghetti with meat sauce.
I got a fish and chips.
Fish and
yummy.
Chips.
We just came back after the first day in Canada. I'm tired.
Me too.
We did a lot.
Yes, we did. So what'd you think? How was your first day in Canada?
Okay, let's take it from the top. We went on the Clipper Ferry.
Mm-hmm.
We had the comfort seats, so it was definitely a lot more cushier than the standard seats on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
The ride itself was okay. The water wasn't too
rough. Yeah.
Rough. The only downside was there was no Wi-Fi.
Mm-hmm.
So we were on the ferry for 3 hours.
It wasn't too bad though, right? I feel like the seats were comfy enough that, you know, it's just nice view and everything. And yeah.
That's true. Oh, and because we were on comfort class, there were certain unlimited snacks and drinks.
Yeah, like potato chips, pretzels, there's some trail mix and bottled water, soda, and then like coffees, like
teas.
You know, yeah, and teas, you're right. Yeah.
We're docked into Canada. We had to go through customs.
Mm-hmm. What'd you think?
It was very different, and I'm glad you warned me because they want to know your business, if you know what I mean. Like, they asked us, where are you going? How long you're going to be here? When you're coming back?
When you're coming back to California.
Yeah, it's not like we have some other type of passport. We're both U.S. citizens, mm-hmm. and it's not like, we want to illegally immigrate to Canada. So after that, we initially were just thinking of dropping off our luggage at the Fairmont Empress Hotel, because I think check-in was 3 or 4, and at the time we got to Canada, it was only 12:30. But then when we told the front desk, they actually said that our rooms were ready, so we were able to check in early. So yeah, we checked in. I like the decor of this room. Mm-hmm. It is Victorian style. The designs and the patterns are very similar to the Grand Floridian hotel that we stayed in when we were in Disney World. It's also Victorian theme too.
Yeah.
At 1, we had our scheduled afternoon tea. We bought the package as
part of the Clipper Vacation.
Yes, correct. The tea experience itself, I liked the ambience. Mm. I liked our waiter. He was very friendly and talkative.
But how did it compare to the Huntington Library experience we went to?
Yeah, I think I do prefer the Huntington Library tea experience. I don't know what it is exactly, but I think I might like the snacks, but the
little
bites.
Yeah.
Finger foods,
yeah, sure.
That sounds so low class.
Yeah. I think they were better at the Huntington Library, but remember we bought like the more expensive package. But price wise, it's pretty similar, I think.
Similar, yeah.
Because this was like 109 Canadian, so that's what, like $80 US? Yeah, anyway, I did like the Huntington one better, but this was good too. Yeah. I mean, I'd recommend it.
After that, we went to the Butchart Gardens. Mm-hmm.
Initially, we tried to take the bus, but we couldn't find the platform, so we just decided to take the Uber. It was like 50, 55 Canadian, which is what, $40, $45, versus like when we took the bus back, it was $5 Canadian for both of us, and which is about $4.50 US. So yeah, how was Butchart?
There were a lot of Asian tourists. Mm-hmm.
Surprisingly, right?
Surprisingly, yeah. Didn't expect that, but I thought it was very beautiful, very luscious and green.
What was your favorite part of the garden?
The sunken garden, for sure. I just, was not expecting that.
Yeah, and everything was blooming in there too, right? Like the rose garden, it wasn't blooming. Japanese garden, not really anything blooming either, but yeah, I guess when we first walked into that like area that opened up with all the like flowers, remember? Yeah, we were like on that overhang looking over, right? Yeah. Like, wow. The lighting was really nice. It wasn't too bright or anything, right? Like you could just see the whole like valley with all the flowers.
Yeah, we were really lucky. The weather was, it sprinkled here and there. But for the most part, it was good, not hot. Yeah, had a very pleasant experience in the gardens.
And it wasn't too crowded, right?
Oh, yes. We came around like 4 o'clock.
Yeah. The Clipper website's a little funny. You can choose to go on the ferry as well as like another like
activity
to do. Originally, we wanted to do Butchart Gardens and the tea, but it wouldn't let us because if you did the Butchart Gardens, you had to like leave on the same day or something weird. And since we were staying the night, that doesn't make any sense.
And then,
we had dinner at that bar and restaurant. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Pleasantly surprised by how good.
Yeah, it was good.
I was expecting it to be, because you know how bar and pub food is. But yeah, the spaghetti I got, it was good. The noodles were a little bit not as soft as I thought it would be, but nonetheless, it was still good.
And my fish and chips was good. The fish was very crispy. The root beer was a little different. I don't know if I prefer that over the usual ones we get, but it was good too.
One thing really weird about the weather is like, oh my God, it would just sprinkle and then stop and sprinkle and then stop. Mm-hmm. So
yeah, that's kind of normal for Pacific Northwest weather. It's like always a small mist or like sprinkling. Alrighty, so we're just gonna take it easy, take a nap, and then tomorrow we'll figure out what to do because it's gonna be raining tomorrow. I don't know, are we gonna catch like a bus to go around the city or probably find indoor things to do?
Right? Yeah, I don't know, museums. We'll see. Mm-hmm. We'll think about it tonight.
All right. Good night.
Good night. See you tomorrow.